The Great Barrier Reef is experiencing a range of threats to its long-term survival. We need to monitor the reef to make sure that it will survive and sustain itself, and that those marine industries that rely on it can continue. The Great Barrier Reef Ocean Observing System is a project managed by AIMS, which is deploying a range of remote systems which collect data for us automatically on the reef. One of the key things we're looking at is climate change and the impact of water temperatures and coral bleaching. This is one of the sensors that we deploy. It sits underneath the buoy in the ocean. It measures temperature, salinity and pressure. The logger collects the information, stores it, and then transmits it via the modem back to the base station and then back to AIMS. One of the key parts to this project is the real-time communications. We're able to get data in real time from these reefs and see things as they're actually happening, and that's really special. Using these technologies and using this data, we can finally get an understanding of how these reefs are going to respond to events like climate change. And this is going to be very important to the future of these coral reef systems.
In 2004, the Great Barrier Reef Marine Park was rezoned. The area that was closed to fishing went from less than 5% to 33%. And given the number of people who were affected, it was important that it should be monitored. So we changed our program specifically to look at the effects of the 2004 rezoning. The AIMS monitoring program spends about 100 days each year at sea and make detailed studies of the fish communities, the corals, and the crown of thorns starfish. When we resurveyed the reefs less than 2 years after the closure, we found that the number of coral trout on reefs that were closed to fishing had increased by, on average, 50%. Such a large and rapid change is very encouraging for the effectiveness of the zoning plan. The AIMS long-term monitoring program has given an idea of the scale and the variability of changes on the barrier reef, and this is clearly of great interest to managers when they're devising strategies to protect it into the future.